Professor Jayendra Bandyopadhyay. Professor Bandyopadhyay is known to me and I'm closely in terms of work for quite some years because we had a strong overlap in Ahmedabad PRL, where he did his PhD with Professor Arul Lakshminarayan, who is right now in IIT Madras. And he also had a strong collaboration with Professor Santhanam, who gave a talk here also. And if you see, Jayendra's CV is one after another physical evaluators on very significant aspects of this entanglement, connection with random matrix theory, and then varieties of very, very interesting things. And in fact, some of his papers, like I have read it with a lot of interest, where this two-level system he has used and to describe this BART's, aviation. So, very strong interest in real application of, quantum coherence, these quantum systems into realistic systems. Now, today he's going to go to Floquet quantum systems. And as you would see, there have been some talks on this kind of thing, this time crystal, then this time dependent and periodic Hamiltonians. They are now a hot area of research in quantum technology, as well as a general physical point of view, near equilibrium states. And many, many aspects. You do time crystal, you will find out Floquet quantum systems are finding use there. And I must say that Jayendra has been one early worker. I think he worked on these things not before this fashion started. So Jayendra, without much shadow, this stage is yours. You can start talking.
Okay, thank you, Professor Panikbhai, for your kind invitation and giving me this chance to speak on this topic. So I am just, for last few years, I am working on this Floquet system. And so I thought maybe I can share. But I understand that these are schools, so I want to keep myself more at the pedagogical level. So I'm not going to discuss that much about my work in this Floquet system. So mostly I'll talk about that basics of the Floquet system. So here is, I am from Bex Pilani campus. Here you can see, can you see my laser pointer here? I can move, moving, it's visible. All of you can see the laser pointer? Okay, yeah, probably you can see. Anyway, so yeah, so this is our campus and Pilani. And so this work mostly I have done with our team members. So this black color name, they are still in Pilani. We are working together. Professor Tapumai Ghosakar is my colleague and other three PhD students. And Tridev Mishra was my previous student. Now he's doing postdoc in Göttingen. Rashmi Gangi, she has also completed a PhD. Now she is already working in some college in Pilani, engineering college in Pilani. And recently I was in South Korea. So this is the recent collaboration I developed with Zuzer from Daejeon, South Korea. Okay. So let me just go to that. So before going into details of that, let me just, because title, for the title, you may not realize that what is the topic we are going to discuss. So we mentioned the Floquet system, a quantum Floquet system. So Floquet system is a very simple idea, because whenever you consider a periodically driven system, and if it is a linear system, then you can apply Floquet theory. And since this, in general, this, and generally people apply Floquet theory to understand or study this kind of system. So this is also known as Floquet system. So Floquet system is nothing but a periodically driven system. Here, particularly we are interested in the quantum system. So that's why the title of my talk, Floquet quantum system. Okay. So now this is the one, before going to details of our plan of my talk, let me just show you that video. So you can see that there's a pendulum. Can you see this? Okay. It's not working properly. Just a piece. So this is a pendulum you can see. So here you can see the pendulum when you are not doing anything, that the stability is at that downward. Okay, that's stable stability of this pendulum. But now suppose this is the 5 watt here, and now you are giving some oscillatory motion to the 5 watt here with very fast oscillation. Okay. So this is the downward power. Yeah. You can see
you see that now there is a new study plan has created.
This is purely due to this happening due to this periodic driving. So you can see that periodic driving can drastically change the stability property of the system. So that upward direction, which was not a stable point when it was static, but when you're applying this periodic driving, so it is this upward direction become another stable point. Okay, so here is the plan of this today's talk, that first I'll give a motivation. Fluke theory from this quantum, particularly from quantum computation information perspective. Basically, I will give you some recent studies in this and quantum computation and information where they use Fluke theory or exploit Fluke, periodically driving idea, and they have achieved certain things. So I'll discuss some of the recent works, and then I'll come to the basics of Fluke theory, and then major goal of this Fluke theory is to design a desired quantum system. Okay, suppose you are given a static system, unriven system, and now your goal, and you have been given one target system or your desired system, and now your goal is to design a driving protocol such that you can achieve that your target system. So this is called Fluke engineering. And here to find at the before concluding, I will discuss one of our very recent work related to this Fluke engineering. Mostly, this is a very technical work, so I will mostly summarize that, the key points of that work. And then finally, I'll come to it. Okay, so motivation. So as I mentioned, that you've seen that what is the Fluke system? Fluke system is periodically driven system. So this is a very general concept. So since it's a very general concept, you can find this application of Fluke theory in all possible fields of physics. So now if you want to talk about the motivation, that motivation can be decided by the which community you are addressing. That suppose you are addressing condensed matter physics, so your motivation can be different. If you are addressing nonlinear dynamics people, quantum chaos people, then can be different. And if you are addressing the quantum computation, quantum information, then your motivation can be different. Because this is a very general subject, so motivation will change from the community to community. Okay? But the general idea of the Fluke theory of Fluke system is same. So, but from considering that here, the most of the participants, they are from the quantum computation and quantum information background, or probably the master students are there, they are who are interested to research in this field. So I just keeping on motivation only from the, or I'm going to discuss some of the recent studies related to this quantum computation, quantum information. Okay, so now this is one first example or plus one of the recent result that this group from China, they applied this periodic driving to realize quantum gates. So basic idea of their work is that only they are mostly motivated from the topological quantum computation. And you probably know that the topological quantum computation is, recently people have studied a lot because it is very much protected from the coherence. I heard that probably Google or Microsoft, some big company, they are investing a lot of money in topological quantum computation. And in topological quantum computation, one way to realize is that by adiabatic evolution. Adiabatic evolution means you are evolving your state very slowly with time. And since this you are evolving this state in very slowly in time, so to complete one gate operation or to complete one computation protocol, you need a lot of time because you have to evolve everything very slowly by adiabatic evolution. So therefore, so people are always looking for whether we can replace the adiabatic evolution by certain means so that you can directly reach to your target state very fast. And that is the shortcut to adiabatic. So people, this group found that the periodic driving can be used to realize the same adiabatic evolution which you wanted to implement in much faster time. So here is one big application of periodic driving in realizing quantum gates, operation of quantum gates. There is another important aspect is that transfer of quantum state from one party to another party. This is part of the quantum communication. And so there are many protocols that are proposed and based on this idea of this shortcut to adiabaticity. So here also the idea is that if you so this is paper is also related to this topological aspect of quantum computation, and there are many protocol proposed based on some other means, and but they try to avoid this shortcut adiabaticity. So that shortcut to adiabaticity was the basic the fundamental of their all this protocol. But this group in that about this very recent work, that's 2019, this group found that if they use periodical driving based protocol, then you can get the much better fidelity. So they found that Fluke actually enhancing the fidelity. So periodic driving enhancing the fidelity than the other proposed protocols. And this also they experimentally realized in a four spin NMR system. So first is first example which I showed, that there is the realization of quantum gates, how fast you can realize quantum gates in topological quantum computation. Second was the how to transfer the state from one party to another in quantum communication protocol. So they are also Fluke and clear crucial group. And then also another work that is also published in 2019, a couple of years back. So they are also, so most of the work here you can see that it is actually addressing the topological quantum computation related. Okay. So here also they found that if you want to speed up this adiabatic evolution, so by other means, so you have to introduce many complex operations. Okay. And there this work is considered, some big people are also involved. Anatoly Kolpakov is a famous person who is one of the person who is actually propagating this idea of Fluke in many different fields, as he also involved in this work. So here in protocol, they designed a scheme for high fidelity quantum state manipulation. Okay? So in quantum computation, you know, you have to change, you have to evolve the state system, or evolve means you have to apply gate and change the state from one state to one constant state, from one state to another state. And so here they use some Fluke-based protocol, and they found that again there's very high fidelity you can manipulate the quantum state. And this approach they applied in the qubit, and so they change the state of the qubit by Fluke protocol, and they achieve very high fidelity. And they have also experimentally their proposed protocol. Can be experimentally realized in nitrogen vacancy center in diamonds. And they estimated one of their collaborators applied their protocol in the real experiment, and they found that the fidelity of the state preparation is very close to one. So this is the initial state manipulation of noisy qubits. And also there is another work which is a very, this is the latest work, very recent one, the 2021. So there they showed that if they locate driving, you can enhance the spin swap. So you know that swap operation in quantum computation. So if you have two qubits given, you have to swap the state of the two qubits. So they showed that by locate means you can, the swap rate that can be increased very fast. You can, swapping rate can be faster. And also quality of the swapping rate can also be very high. So in this work, they mostly consider the Ising model, Ising system, a couple single triplet qubits. And they mostly consider this quantum dot system. And they showed that by periodic driving, they can enhance the quality factor of this spin eigen state swaps. Okay, so swapping, so they showed that the Fluke driving, you can actually get the very high quality swapping operation. And this is also the experiment realized in gallium arsenide and aluminum gallium arsenide heterostructure. And they also propose that the same protocol can be used in the silicon quantum dot. So this is the few examples which are shown that where people have used Fluke, idea of Fluke system have been periodic driving to realize or to achieve certain goal in quantum computation, mostly to get a faster communication or communication with faithful communication, and the quality of the gate operation. So quality of the gate operation, they increase the quality of the gate operation, they also increase the state of the qubit. All this possible by locating, by periodic drive. So this is the most thing I can say that this can motivate you to study Locke system. You means those who are interested in quantum computation, quantum information. So for this community also, this Locke can be a very Locke-based protocol can be a very useful and can be important. Okay, so with this, I think I give some rough motivation that why this community, quantum information and quantum computation or quantum communication or quantum technology community, they should also look for this Locke-based protocol to improve the their goal. Okay, and that's okay. Sorry. Yeah, so this is, so yeah, with this, this motivation part is over. Now I'm coming to this basics of Locke theory. So here I am giving this, I'm discussing this mostly on based on these three papers, which one is a very recent one, couple of years back, published in Annual Review of Condensed Matter Physics, and one is in New Journal of Physics. And there is a big review article in published in Advances in Physics. Okay. So this discussion on the Locke theory will be based on, mostly based on these three references. Okay, so as we told you, the Locke theory means your system has periodic drive. So that means if you want, if you consider, so that means if your Hamiltonian should be a time periodic, okay? Time, so since it is a time dependent, was a time periodic, that means your system is time dependent. So Hamiltonian should have this property. It is time periodic, where T is the period of that driving. So where omega is the corresponding angular frequency. Now, since your system is time dependent, so you have to now consider time dependent Schrödinger equation for the study this quantum dynamics or quantum evolution of the system. So this is that the time dependent Schrödinger equation I have considered. So now, what is Locke theory? Locke theory based on the fundamental idea is of Locke theory. So now what is Locke theorem? Locke theorem is exploiting this particular property of Hamiltonian, that Hamiltonian has time periodicity. Okay. So because of this time periodicity, according to Locke theorem, so any solution of this time-dependent Schrödinger equation can be written in this form. Si and D are the n possible solutions of this independent solution of the time-dependent Schrödinger equation. And then that can be written as one U and D, another state. And multiplied with some phase kind of term, phase factor, this is e to the power minus I epsilon n t over h bar. Okay, so this is the Locke theorem, and according to Locke theorem, this particular state u n t, which should be also periodic, and its periodicity will be the same as the periodicity of the Hamiltonian. Okay, so this I and t state, which are the solution of the differential, this time dependent Schrödinger equation, they are called Locke states. The epsilon n, which is a real parameter, is called quasi energies, and u and t, which is called the Locke modes. So Locke modes are time periodic, but Locke states, they are not time periodic, because you can see that even though this part is time periodic, but this one is not time periodic. So therefore, this I and t, this is time periodic. Now, this is exactly the temporal analog of Bloch theory. In Bloch theorem, the Hamiltonian, we consider that it is spatially periodic. If you consider 1D case, then the potential of this, for some consider lattice system, so potential of that lattice would have this form where the time, sorry, this spatially periodic with this lattice constant A. And in according to Bloch theorem, is the solution of this Schrödinger equation should be of the form where E is to I kx, which is equivalent to just like this factor, and ux, okay? And ux is just periodic with same periodicity as your Hamiltonian. Or I mean, this periodicity Hamiltonian is coming from this periodicity in the potential. And so this is just same as this Locke theorem, but Locke theorem is defined in the position, it's position space. And it is here it's called quasi energy, where K is called quasi momentum. But here I want to mention that Locke theorem, that Locke's original theory was not related to quantum theory or any classical theory. That was actually purely mathematical theory for solving differential equation. Couple linear differential equation and whose coefficients are time periodic. So for that set of differential equation, Locke developed his theory in 1850 or 60s around that. So even though block, which we call block theorem in solid state physics, that is just a extension of Floquet theorem or just a special case of Floquet theorem. Okay. So Floquet is not a newer thing, Floquet is original idea. Okay. So in block, in solid state system, we also call the Brillouin zone. You will know that you can go from the real space to reciprocal space, and then you can define the Brillouin zone there. Here also, you can go to reciprocal space. So reciprocal space, then you can also define this something called Floquet Brillouin zone. And Floquet Brillouin zone would be defined like this. Okay. So epsilon n, the quasi energy, should be within this range, minus half a equal omega to half a equal omega. This is exactly like in Brillouin zone of the spatially periodic case, where this momentum, okay, this quasi momentum, this can you know that the quasi momentum should be within minus pi over a to pi a to plus pi over a. Okay, so exactly the similar idea also possible. You can think about in this time periodic case, which is called the Floquet Brillouin zone. So here is one passing remark that in case of the spatially periodic Hamiltonian, quasi momentum can be chosen to lie within a single reciprocal lattice cell, such as the first Brillouin zone. So you know that in those of studies of physics, you know that in quasi you can fold back everything into the first Brillouin zone, and then you can study the whole solid state system, band diagram, everything. So here also these quasi energies can also be chosen to lie within the interval of with h by omega, which you can call the first Floquet Brillouin zone, like this which I have defined here. Okay, and now this question is that what is this Floquet state? I just mentioned here this is the solution of the time dependent Schrödinger equation. But what is that? How to get that? So these Floquet states are just the eigenstate of this time evolution operator, which is defined within one driving period. So if you are defining a time evolution operator from initial some particular time t0, and then t0 plus capital T, where T is the time period of the Hamiltonian, which is responsible for this this time evolution, then this int0 will be the eigenstate of this time evolution operator. And its eigenvalue will be of this form, which is this factor, this case factor also appeared in this Floquet theorem. Okay. So this is the Floquet states, which is a solution of the time dependent Schrödinger equation, that is nothing but the eigenstate of this time evolution operator defined within one driving protocol. And so here, as I mentioned, I can see that the eigenvalues, these eigenvalues are independent of initial time t0. Okay. So this is not dependent on what is your starting value of starting time. Okay. What is your initial time? So this factor, this eigenvalue is independent of that. So therefore, by diagonalizing this time evolution operator, you can determine the eigenstate. Here, another concept I should introduce here, that is called Floquet Hamiltonian. So this time evolution operator, which is defined within this one single timing period, we can always write down this as an exponential of I over h bar t h t 0 f. What is this h t 0 f? Here, h t 0 f is some time independent Hamiltonian, which is called Floquet Hamiltonian. So this is what is what we are trying to say here, that if you have a time evolution operator defined within this time t0 to t0 plus capital T, then you can define one time independent Hamiltonian, which is called Floquet Hamiltonian, such that this is that this time evolution operator should be equal to of this form. And then what is this Floquet Hamiltonian? So Floquet Hamiltonian, the eigenstate of this Floquet Hamiltonian will be this Floquet mode, which we have mentioned earlier in defining this Floquet theorem. So this is the Floquet modes are the eigenstate of this this Floquet Hamiltonian, and this quasi energy which are defined there will be the eigenvalue of this static Hamiltonian. So therefore, the quasi energies. By diagonalizing this time evolution operator, we can get the eigenstate as well as the quasi energies. Okay. And now if you want to know what is the meaning of this relation, suppose you are observing the system stroboscopically. Stroboscopically means, suppose you have an initial time in T0, then you're observing the system at T0 plus T, T0 plus twice T, T0 plus 3T, and so on, and T0 plus NT. Okay, so periodically you are observing. then the time independent Hamiltonian HTF0F will play the role of effective Hamiltonian for time the dynamics. Okay, so that means if you want to observe the system only at T0, T0 plus T, T0 plus 2T, then you can think that this dynamics is governed by this time independent Hamiltonian. Okay, but if you want to see the what is happening in between, okay, the T0 to T0 plus T within that, or T0 T plus T to T0 plus 2T, so then that will be that you can then for that will be purely time dependent effect, and that is called microversion. Okay, and so that dynamics so is determined by some time dependent, can define some time dependent Hamiltonian for that, but this static Hamiltonian or time independent Hamiltonian describe the stochastic dynamics of the system. Okay, so this is the stochastic dynamics system. So this is one static Hamiltonian called Floki Hamiltonian, and the dynamics which is happening or taking place within the period. Okay, so that is called microversion. Okay, now and if you want to find the want to determine the this Floki state at any arbitrary time psi and t, so I showed you that psi and t is the economic Floki theorem, this is the solution. So you want to get that. So if you are given a psi and t zero, then this if you apply this time evolution operator, which is evolving a state from time t0 to a state at time t, so then you get this Floki state at any arbitrary time. Here one thing it should be important, so that's why you should remember that here the eigenvalues is e to the power minus of I epsilon t by h bar, and the eigenstate is I and t zero, they are unique. Okay, so they are unique. This is the eigenstate of here, that's only this is unique. But however, the quasi energies epsilon n and the Floki modes u and t, they are not unique. Okay, so suppose I have given you a solution of this time dependent Schrodinger equation, which is a time dependent time periodic driving, and you have given the solution, and that means you know what is u and t and epsilon n, then one can label some other quasi energies by introducing an integer n index n such that epsilon n plus m h bar omega. So what I am doing telling you that suppose you have a time dependent solution of that time dependent Schrodinger equation is given, and this is you know that u and t and epsilon n, then suppose you are defining another quasi energy which is epsilon n plus some integer multiple of h bar omega. Okay, and then the corresponding Floki modes you define as this u and t multiplied by some of this phase factor e to the power I m omega t, then you can find that this I and t, which is the eigenstate of this time, eigenstate of this operator or solution of the time dependent Schrodinger equation, then you can, which is unique, which is unique means, okay, you mean to say that here, which this will you always get a single solution for that, and for that you can get the multiple. Okay, I may not use the word unique here. I can get all the same one solution, and for corresponding to that, there is a multiple main possible solution up there for different Floki modes and different this spectrum. Okay, so these two will give you the same solution for the time dependent Schrodinger. Okay, actually, what I am telling you the unique that is not should be opposite one. These are many possible solutions that there. Okay, and now if you substitute this in this form, this I and t equal to u and t, and also this one in this time dependent Schrodinger equation. Okay, so these are all solution of the same time dependent Schrodinger equation. Okay, so then we can get something called a quasi energy operator, which is a function of t, and we have, what is this qt? What is that? The qt is this ht, which is our time dependent time periodic Hamiltonian minus I h by dt. Now if we apply this operation in on u n m t, then you will get this results. Okay, so you can see here it's a very strange kind of eigenvalue relation which you are getting. Why I am calling this strange? In quantum mechanics, when you talk about time independent Hamilton case, then your time independent Hamilton acts on some state and give you back some energy eigenvalue multiplied by that state. Okay, here this operator is not that kind of static operator. This is ht minus I h bar dt. It is a purely time dependent operator, and here this is a time dependent state. When it is acting on this time dependent state, it is giving you back the same time dependent state with this quasi energy epsilon in it. Okay, so this is a very strange kind of, you can say that very strange kind of Eigenvalue relation. And this is this, so you can clearly see that this is just like an Eigenvalue relation, but this Eigenvalue relation is actually you can obtain in extended Hilbert space. What is this extended Hilbert space? Suppose you have a actually your system is what your system is in this Hilbert space H, and this then you are driving the system, then you can define one Hilbert space which you are calling F or extended Hilbert space. That will be the tensor product of your original Hilbert space with this Hilbert space LT. And what is this LT? LT is a space of square integral T periodic time dependent functions. Okay. So e to the power I m omega t, this where m is all possible integer, this is the, so this Hilbert space LT is formed by this state, okay, e to the power I m omega t. Okay. So now if in this case you call a state m in this LT Hilbert space, so that means this is in some particular basis, this will be just e to the power I m omega t. Okay. So now this q, which is defined in this way, now if you can also do another thing, since your time dependency in the system is periodic, so you can also go, we also transform your system from the time space to this frequency space. That means you can give it a Fourier transformation. So your Hamiltonian HT is the time dependent, time periodic, and you can go from this time periodic time domain to frequency domain by Fourier transformation. And this is just a Fourier definition of Fourier transformation, and you can get this HM, where HM, and you can also show that this is also H minus M dagger. Okay. So this is the Fourier transformation. So that means what you are doing here. So you have originally system is you have defined in on Hilbert space H, and then you are driving, and driving can be defined, any periodic driving you know can be expanded in the Fourier series. And when you expand the Fourier series, then you can expand in terms of this time periodic function. Okay. And then since the time periodic time periodicity, you can give a Fourier transformation, and you can transform everything from that time domain to frequency domain. Okay. And so whole this time dependent Hamiltonian you can write also in the frequency domain, and that by this the transformation. And then this QT operator, which is a very strange looking operator, H2 minus I by dvt, and which is giving you this strange kind of Eigenvalue relation. So by this Fourier transformation, you can write this Q hat T as a Q bar, and then you will get this, get the matrix of this form, where this H0, which you can see here, H0 is the undriven Hamiltonian, okay? Hamiltonian without any driving. And since now you are adding this driving, so you are getting, and since you are then you are transforming it into frequency space, so all this time dependency has now transformed into the frequency domain in this form. So in all these diagonal blocks, where H0 is the undriven, then H0 minus H bar omega, H0 is all diagonal, you can see that H0 is there with some integer multiple of omega with H bar omega. And these are the some H minus 1, H1 that is actually connecting this diagonal block. Okay. So if this H minus 1, H1 is 0, then all H minus 1, H1 or all the off diagonal blocks are 0, then you'll get only block diagonal. Okay. So then that is not a very interesting thing, because you are separating all these blocks. Okay. That can also happen when this driving frequency is very, very strong. Okay. So driving frequency very, very strong means if you consider this your undriven system, H0, and if you consider it all possible characteristic frequency, characteristic frequencies, then, and if the driving frequency is much, much higher than this, the characteristic frequency H0, then this terms of diagonal terms will be almost negligible. Okay. So anyway, so now what is this H minus 1, H minus 2 and plus 1 also? This is defined here. Okay. So now I can tell you that if Vt, if your time dependent potential is just V0 cos omega t, and then you can write down this under exponential form, it will be, you'll get this. Then from this relation, you can clearly see that if you want to go from time to Fourier domain, then only in cases when these H plus minus M are less than 2, then then it will be non-zero. And when it is m greater than or equal to 2, then this will be 0. So that means for this kind of driving, where only one driving frequency is there, omega, so then this h minus 2, h minus 3, all this thing will be 0 block. Only this off-diagonal block will be non-zero, okay, for single. Now, if you are considered driving of v0 cos omega t plus some v1 cos twice omega t, then this h plus 2, h minus 2 will be non-zero block, but h plus 3, minus 3, and higher order block will all be zero. Okay. Here is in, and this q bar is now I have defined this this extended Hilbert space. So you can see that why from this form you can see that why you're calling this extended Hilbert space. H0 is defining your original Hilbert space, and now you are defining this bigger matrix. And this is happening, this is coming due to the time-dependent driving, time-periodic driving, so that's what we call extended Hilbert space. So basically, this is a infinite dimensional matrix. So okay, so original H is becoming now infinite dimensional matrix. Okay. So this is if you want to describe this thing from tutorially. So this is your system, okay, and then you are applying this some periodic driving. Let's say you are applying laser. And then this system, you can see, you can get that one layer, which is defining our Hilbert space H. Then due to this driving, you can consider they are forming many layers, okay? These many layers actually like this diagonal block. So these are many layers they are forming, infinite number of layers are forming. So this is your H0 block, H0 layer, and this is the H1 layer and H minus 1. So if you want to go from H0 to H1 or H0 to H minus 1, so either you have to absorb some photon. So in this language, if you consider the language of photon, which the photon is coming from this periodic driving. So then in that language, you can say that if you want to go from this layer to another layer, then you have to absorb photon. Or if you want to go to another layer, you have to then release photon. And that is why this off-diagonal block, you can see the energies are at some minus H bar omega or plus H bar omega. So if you want to go from here to here, you have to release some photon to reach this layer. And if you want to go to this layer, then you have to absorb some photon. Okay. And then and this will be infinite number of possible layers you can think of. And from this, you can also define some H effective Hamiltonian by projecting all the effect of this all. So as I mentioned that earlier in this previous slide, there is an infinite dimensional Hamiltonian you have constructed. But if you want to study the system, you cannot deal with the infinite dimensional system. But if you approximately what you can do, there are certain kind of theory is also there, perturbation theory, so that you can project out the effect of this higher order these other layers onto this original layer. Okay, and then you can define one effective Hamiltonian. Okay. So this an effective this and now this is effective. So basically, what is now happening, there's this one layer is supposed to your original system is some lattice system, okay, that is forming some 1D lattice system, H0, okay, so that is one dimension is there, and now we can creating another dimension in this direction, okay, so that dimension is called Floquet directions, which is determined by this index M, okay, so that we know that effectively are 2D dimensions, two dimensions, okay. So now if you consider for two incommensurate driving, so this is I am telling all theory for the only one frequency. Now if you consider system has two frequencies, omega 1 and omega 2, and they are incommensurate. Then you can construct another the Floquet direction. So instead of one Floquet direction M, you can define now two Floquet directions, M1 and M2. And from within this one dimensional system, you can effectively realize a 3D system. And then people have already experimentally and theoretically people have already proposed this quantum Hall effect in this MX space, and people have also done this experimentally. Okay. So Floquet based this realization of or Floquet based this in this in increase in dimension is already being experimentally realized. Okay. Now coming to so now you can see that this is the whatever I told you now that it seems like that this idea of extended Hilbert space is just a mathematical exercise to study this kind of system. But recently, some 8 years back, people have actually experimented with some bismuth selenium. And they experimentally found that your this is some system they consider this Bismarck selenium, and this is a topological insulator. And there they found that they really have observed this idea of expanding Hilbert space, and they found that this kind of this multiple. So this is the center part is for that state, this crossing that is the coming from the undriven system, and these are all higher order things are coming from this. They are considered, since we are considering this driving, and we are considering this flow other m, the different m values. So okay, so this is come, this part is coming from m equal to zero. This is from m plus minus one, and this is m plus one. So experimentally, they have realized this kind of idea, the flow case, that is also called flow case zone. Okay, so this idea of flow case zone, they have observed in experimentally in this Bismarck selenium. So this idea of this expanding Hilbert space is not just a mathematical exercise. This is actually physically you can realize. So before this work, which is published in Science in 2013, people have some doubt that whether even though this Floquet theory is okay, this nice theory, we can study the periodical driven system, but whether this idea of Floquet bands or all these things have some physical meaning or not, but this result showed that, okay, no, there's some physical meaning. Okay, and now, okay, so this is the most general result. So now I can come to a very special case which people are studying a lot, that is the high frequency case. Now, what is the high frequency case? High frequency case, I just mentioned just a few minutes back, that when the driving frequency higher than any characteristic frequency of the undriven system, okay, then you call that is a high frequency case. And then only if for the high frequency case, then you need to consider only very few photon spectra. Let's say you have to consider only m equal to 0 plus minus 1. Because for the higher values of this m, these higher blocks will not have much effect on this central layer. Okay. So that means from that figure, which has the infinite layers over there, so you can now think of this, we need only three layers. Okay. So these three layers can explain that high frequency case. And from these three layers, you can calculate what is the effect coming to. So H0 was in the your static Hamiltonian, then you are driving it with some time periodic driving. And for the high frequency case, you can get an H effective Hamiltonian, which is also a static Hamiltonian. And this you can get, this effective Hamiltonian you can get from the perturbation theory that is called, there is many different kind of perturbation theories available. So this is one perturbation theory I mentioned, that's called Van Vleck perturbation theory. And from using the Van Vleck perturbation theory, you can get this effective Hamiltonian at the high frequency limit up to order of 1 by omega square. Okay. So this is the effective Hamiltonian. So this is the Floquet engineering, that actually their goal is mainly is this. So H0 is the given state. Now if you have a desired state, and that desired state is your H effective Hamiltonian, so then what will be the driving protocol so that you get this H effective? Okay. So yeah, depends. So that driving protocol, if the driving protocol gives you this H effective, which is your desired Hamiltonian, that means your Floquet-based protocol is successful. And where the HM is already, I have given the same definition. And this effective, so this effective Hamiltonian actually describes the stroboscopic dynamics. So as I mentioned, that if you want to study the system stroboscopically, and then this is the Hamiltonian which will describe that. And now Floquet engineering, probably I have to skip the work which I want to talk about my own work. I may skip that. Anyway, that is not very important. So maybe I come to the very important concept of Floquet engineering. So Floquet engineering, a major goal of is to design a driving protocol such that at a high frequency limit, one can obtain a desired effective Floquet Hamiltonian H effective starting from a given undriven Hamiltonian H. So if your static Hamiltonian is given H0, and you have to have desired Hamiltonian, which is called effective Hamiltonian. So you have to design your high frequency limit. You have to design a driving protocol such that at a high frequency limit, you will get your desired Hamiltonian. One example is the people have already done, that is a laser as irradiated graphene. Graphene, you know, those who are in attending any solid condensed matter talk, you have seen that being a large number of talks on discuss graphene. So graphene is a hexagonal lattice which is formed by the carbon atoms. And at the tight binding limit, you can assume that only nearest neighbor hopping of the electrons are allowed. So this is the Hamiltonian. Okay. And for the graphene is interesting because at this particular value of this K, this in this reciprocal space, their Venn diagram is becoming like this. Okay, so if you zoom that, so at this point they are touching each other. So this is called Dirac point, because around this point, if you want to look at the system here around this point, this is a linear dispersion relation you can get, and this is just a similar to the relativistic particle. But here, the mathematically this is just like a relativistic this energy bands are touching linearly. This is mathematically equivalent to that that relativistic idea. But that electron here is not moving in the relativistic speed. Okay, so electrons moving in this graphene, their speed is at least three order less than the relativistic speed, or speed is three or less of the speed of light. Okay, so this is, and they are moving with this Fermi velocity. Okay? So that is three order less. So, but this is, the dispersion relation is just like a relativistic kind of. So people have, this is very interesting system graphene, because you can realize, experimentally realize many of the ideas of relativistic quantum mechanics in this system. And now if you are radiating this system by laser, and this is a laser directed field ET, if you consider ET, and then ET from this classical electrodynamics, you know that ET can be written as in terms of the time derivative of the vector potential. And AT, and if you are driving, if our laser is a circularly polarized, then AT can have, you can have this form, the cos omega t is sin omega t. Then this Jij, what is the Jij? Ji is the theta, is the hopping strength of electron from one side to another side, nearest neighbor side. Okay, and this hopping parameter is now modified by the driving, and it is becoming time dependent. And this time dependent hopping function is becoming like this. Okay, so Jij is the original hopping, and that is now modulated by this exponential factor, which is time dependent. And what is the Ri? Ri is the position of the ith side. So hexagonal lattice, the different sides are there. So I is noting that sides. And now applying this perturbative formula, which I have given here, they apply this perturbative formula and derive the H effect. So you can see that for new this effective Hamiltonian, which has nearest neighbor term is there. Okay, so nearest neighbor hopping still is happening. But additional to that, next nearest neighbor hopping is also allowed. So that means earlier only here to here this hopping was allowed, but due to this driving, now you can go from here to here. And because of this next nearest neighbor hopping is allowed, so this term actually breaks the something called chiral symmetry. Because this chiral symmetry, this Dirac point was happening, and now the chiral symmetry is broken. So this, which is, there is a touching, the band touch was happening, that is actually there at the same point there is a band gap is open. Okay, so the driving, what it has done, this periodic driving, particularly the circularly polarized driving, is opening a gap at this point. Okay, so, and in addition to that, it is developing a edge current. Okay, so that means originally the graphene was not a topological property, so, but now it has some topological property. That is, topological property means it has only, current is flowing only at the edge, and the bulk part there is no current. So the laser, so this thing, this graphene, sorry, this laser, circularly polarized laser can open the band gap in graphene, and also it can transform it into a topological system. Okay, so my idea was to talk about my recent work, but it's a bit technical one, so I don't know whether I should skip this thing, Professor Panigrahi. Can you just tell me?
You can broadly point out, then
maybe I'll highlight it.
Because yours is the last talk, you can take a few more minutes, you can broadly point out.
Thank you. Okay, so till now what I have discussed, that is mainly of the general property of the Floquet system and Floquet this engineering, all those things. So recently we have done our work related to the Floquet engineering. I just giving you a summary of that. So this is the idea which we have designed a Floquet driving protocol. So idea is the same. You have a given state static coming to an H0, and now you want to design a driving protocol such that you can get your desired Hamiltonian. And here you consider a system which has underlying Lie algebraic structure. Okay, So before going into that, what is that? Let me just give you the another version of the Floquet theorem. As I, from the very beginning, I mentioned the Floquet theorem that is defined for the state, but also you can define a Floquet theorem at the operator level. So this is the time-dependent Schrodinger equation in the operator form for the time-dependent operator u t equal h t u t. Here we are assuming h bar equal to 1. Then according to Floquet theorem, this is exactly the same, which is there. Earlier, which I defined the Floquet theorem in the state, in terms of state, and now we are defining in terms of operator. But these are exactly the same. So the solution of this time-dependent Schrodinger equation can always be written in this form. PET multiplied by e to the power minus I h effective t, where this PET is also time periodic, and this is called this micro-motion operator. So, okay, so you remember that in the state case, here you had this I t, you had this u t, then e to the power minus I epsilon t. Okay. So instead of ut, now is pt, now which is now an operator, and this is called a micro-motion operator, which is also time period. So this is just a equivalent thing what we discussed earlier. And now, what kind of system which you consider? As I mentioned, you consider on the system having Lie algebraic structure. So let us consider for a general or a very general case, so time independent Hamiltonian is H0, which is of this form. Okay, H0, some identity matrix, and H alpha, A alpha, where it is A operators A alpha, they are forming an n-dimensional Lie algebra. Okay. So since they are forming a closed Lie algebra, so they satisfy this commutation relation. So that means if you take any two operator and calculate their commutator, then you get back a linear combination of this operator. And this constant which is sitting here, that is called structure constant, that define the underlying algebra. Now our goal is to find, so this is H0 given Hamiltonian, and now we want to design one H effective. Okay? Our goal is to now to find our time dependent potential Vt, the time period potential Vt, which should be of this form. Again, this is so earlier here this H0 was this constant, these are all time independent constant, and now these are some time dependent functions we have introduced. And so now our goal is to determine the what will be the H0 t or this Ft function, such that you can get this H effect. And where this F, since you want to do everything in the Floquet domain, so we expect that Vt is the time period, and here Vt is defined in this way. So this time periodicity of Vt is coming from this time dependent function. Okay. So this and this time period. So this is we derived the full general formalism. If you, I have given this archive, now we have communicated this thing. For publication, so you can find this in the archive, and you can see that this we have derive a very general formalism how to get this H effective. And but then, as an example, we consider a very particular case where this system has following SU2 algebra. SU2 algebra means this is a spin up particle kind of thing that is can so that means the A, this operator instead of operator A, that should be like SYSZ, where this is a spin operator. You can use this representation of this SU2 algebra, or also you can use another representation, that is S plus S minus, where S plus is just a linear combination of Sx and Sy, and S minus also that with some I. So you know from your basic quantum mechanics what is S plus and S minus. So there are two possible representation possible when using under SU2 algebra. And so here I'm just summarize that I knew that I cannot discuss my work very in detail. So I have already written it in summary form. So for this SU2 case, since it is a spin hub kind of system, that means these are only two state system. So two state system in like in qubit is just two state system, and spin always two state system. But in solid state physics, if you consider then two state system, that means a two band system. So for a given momentum k, you have a two state system, but if you consider all possible values of k, then you get a two bands. So there is a this so SU2 kind of system in solid state. There is a two, there generally a two band system, and two band system you can find in any interacting system, also not large number of non interacting system, and this can also possible in any dimension, 1D, 2D, 3D, many different dimension you can get the two band system. Interacting case, there is a, I can tell you one immediate example. I can tell you that unconventional superconductivity, if you consider unconventional superconductor, PUF superconductor, then that is the interacting system. And in that case, you can also in the mean field approximation, you can write that as a two state system or two band system. And there are many non-interactive systems there also. You can get a two-bus, like graphene. Graphene is also, we consider there is no interaction among electrons in flowing in the graphene, then graphene can also be written as a two-band product, as in non-interactive. So many physically relevant systems are two-bands. And then now how to solve this problem? So we solve this problem in this way. There is a well-known answer given in the 60s by Y and Norman. So they are giving that for this kind of case, when your time dependent Schrodinger equation, where this HT has the time period, then this UT can be written as a product of this exponential operator, where this exponential, you can see the SZ, S minus, S plus, and this identity is sitting here. So if your system is time dependent system is time is this this some time dependent Schrodinger equation is underlying algebra is given, then if you know this the one of the representation, then this time evolution part can be written as a product of the exponential of those operator which are forming closed algebra. And from the and as we mentioned, this is a PKT, which is a micro motion operator. It has a time periodicity. So this, and since this operator time periodic, and this, okay, one thing I have not mentioned here, this is this coefficient mk0, mk plus, mk minus, mkz, they are all time dependent. And since this is operator is time periodic, those for this individual, the time dependent function, they should be time periodic. And from the initial condition that you know that if we consider the time evolution operator and consider there is no time evolution, that in t equal to zero, then you should expect that time evolution should give you identity. And then on this condition, you get that this time dependent function should be zero at time t equal to zero. And from the last conditions, from last two conditions, that these two conditions, you can say that the coefficient should be zero at every time interval nt, where n is some integer. And so now in this whole this formalism, what we did that is we know that our goal is to design this effective Hamiltonian, which is our desired Hamiltonian. And that Hamiltonian, as I mentioned, that will describe the dynamics at a time at stroboscopically. That means if you want to see that, want to observe the dynamics at time t, twice t, 3t, then this effective Hamiltonian gives describe that dynamics. But this micro motion part, the dynamics happening within one period, that is not unique. Okay, so from t to 2t, that how we can go from dynamics happening from t to 2t, dynamics within this short time is not unique. Okay, so that means if your starting point is fixed, your end point at time t, capital T, is fixed, but you can reach from one point to another point many different paths. And so that's why this micro motion operation is not unique. So since the micro motion is not unique, so we have the freedom of choosing this time dependent function. Okay, so what is this, how we choose this, how we use this freedom? Our goal is to that we have to design your driving protocol, and you have to design your driving protocol such that it is that should be experimentally realizable. Okay, so that means if you happen to want to define or design a driving protocol, let's say long range hopping by time dependent driving, then that will be not experimentally realizable. So that way we have exploited this freedom, and we define this MKT, and from this we design the driving protocol MKT. Okay, so this is the basically, you can the technical paper, if you're interested, you can see that in archive version is there. Okay, so finally I just want to conclude that so first I'll give you the motivation for studying flow system in this context of quantum computation and information. Then we discuss this basics of flow theory. And then we discussed the flow engineering, one example of graphene and the laser. So this is the first time, or I think this is a very important result in this direction, when the people can modify this graphene by shining laser. And then we just mentioned, summarize our recent work on flow engineering. And those who are interested in this thing, there's many other field or interesting topics are there in Floquet. So like Floquet topological insulator, Floquet generative flat bands. Now people are talking about ultra fast spintronics and Floquet, then Floquet PT symmetric system, topological system, Floquet open system, quantum open system. People are studying a lot, and nowadays people are studying quantum open system equivalent driving, Floquet based energy band engineering. So if you want to modify the energy band of a given system, how to do that by time period driving. Floquet based many body physics, quantum field theory. That is, these two people are now thinking that how to go in this direction. And at the beginning, Professor Panigrahi mentioned, I just missed that here, the Floquet time system. Okay, so that is also an important direction. And I acknowledge this financial support from there. I did my Floquet engineering work there, and my team members for helping me to understand the subject gradually. And still I am in the learning process. I am learning even new thing every day about this Floquet. So thank you very much.
Very, very nice talk. Very nice talk. Open for questions and discussions.
Yes, Mahbub, you can unmute yourself and ask.
Sir, I have a query, not question, that when you were discussing about that effective Hamiltonian, and what you did that you had an Hamiltonian, and that you did a Fourier transformation, and at that time we got HM. So when we are doing H0, H1, H2, so basically H0 is the base level Hamiltonian, and H1 is the higher level, and H2 is another, and similar with H-1. So what I am asking is that after Fourier transformation, what we are getting HM. So when we are applying it to Van Vleck, or eventually we have Magnus expansion type of thing. So at that situation, HM, what we are getting is changing the value of M after having the expression for HM. So from that, there we can get H0 and H1, H2. Is it correct?
I'm not getting fully. So basically, two different things. When you are writing that this H0, H1, this big matrix, infinite dimensional matrix, which are talking about, that is written in this Floquet Hilbert space, also called this extended Hilbert, space. In that space, we have written that. And then I have shown the perturbation theory. Okay? So these are two different ideas. So different idea in the sense that first, so here I have shown, giving you the result from the Van Vleck based perturbation theory. There is another result is also available in the literature, that is called Brillouin-Wigner. Okay? So in the Brillouin-Wigner, I have not shown here. So Brillouin-Wigner actually directly use that structure, that infinite dimensional structure. And they, in that formalism, they define a particular way how to project the effect of the higher photon sector to the zero photon sector. Okay, and then you get the effective Hamiltonian. And then you get term by term, one by omega, all this. Here, roughly, I can say you that when you are considering the high frequency case, and I have shown you the result for the high frequency expansion of the effective Hamiltonian. In that case, in the high frequency case, you have to consider only very few photon sector. Let's say photon sector 0, 1, plus, minus 1. Okay.
Yeah.
That will effectively give you that. So there is two.
Actually, for higher frequency, the higher order term will be cancelled out.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes. So concern is that will be negligible. Okay, that will be negligible. So there are two ways you can study. You can use the perturbation theory to calculate the effective Hamiltonian. Otherwise, you can diagonalize that. Let's say if you have two state system you are considering, and that means your H0 is the two dimension, two state system, two dimensional Hilbert space. Now, if you are considering the high frequency case, three photon sector, that means your this effect is Hamiltonian in this extended Hilbert space will be six dimension. Okay, so you can. Mm-hmm. You can diagnose the six dimensional. You can get this all these Floquet bands, all these things, zero photon sector, what is happening to the band, all these things. So that also one way to study that, what is happening to the zero photon sector, higher photon sector. Because these are also physical, as I mentioned, one of the science paper, that is also a physical thing that you can experimentally, people have realized the higher photon sector bands. Okay. So there are two ways I can see in the literature people are addressing this issue. One is this effective Hamiltonian that you can calculate mostly at a high frequency case. But if your frequency is not that high, almost at the order of the any characteristic frequency of the unreal system or less than that, then this this extra Hilbert space idea that is, so then you don't have any other option than to study this this big matrix.
Big matrix. So thank you, sir. And I would like to interact with you over email because I'm really very interested in this matter. Okay. So can I get your email ID anywhere?
Maybe You can search my name there in digital and simple
time. Okay, sir. You will definitely find me. Okay, 1 or 2 days. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Other questions?
So there are a few questions from YouTube. Should I read it?
Yeah.
Okay. So there is a question by Kamlesh. What is quasi energy operator and can the eigenvalue corresponding to that operator be complex or it is real?
So what is quasi energy operator? Uh-huh. So this one maybe this one, I guess. Yeah. So this is QT is a QT which are defined here. QT is a the operator. This is the time dependent operator. This is time dependent state. This is time dependent state, but this epsilon nm is the time independent constant. I mean, time independent thing. This operator. So, yeah, so this is time independent epsilon. And what is the other question? This is time independent, dependent or independent? That is what you're asking. So this is time independent.
He just want to know that can it be means energy eigenvalue will be complex or will it be
no, this is a real this is real and this is time independent. This is effectively in the basically in the extended Hilbert space this operator is basically becoming just like a time independent Hermitian operator. Okay.
So there is a question by Mahbub. Can you ask the question or should I read it?
Keep all the only
answer. Just keep it, please.
What is the advantage of frequency domain DB? Okay. So the next question is. This is also from YouTube. What will be the effect of spin in Plouquet theory? And how the spin of the particle will affect quantum Hall effect?
Effect of spin, Plouquet theory. Yeah, so I just mentioned the special case that a 2D case, the spin system. So if you have a spin system, and if you want to, even in the spin system, if you want to design, want to design certain Hamiltonian, then also Plouquet you can apply. I don't see the effect of spin on Plouquet, but rather you can ask the opposite question. What is the effect of Plouquet or periodic driving on the spin system? That has some meaning. I don't understand what is the meaning of the question which that person has asked. Because I don't see any meaning in that. Other way around the question has been that what is the effect of Plouquet on the spin half case? Yeah, so that is always there. So for the two van case, basically I have done exactly the same thing. We apply Plouquet theory to studies two van system. Even you can apply Plouquet theory to study qubits. Okay, so that is our motivation part. When I discuss in motivation, I have given this example. They are mostly to study the qubits, which can be realized in the by spin, and what is the effect of that periodic driving on that.
Okay, so there is last question. I think so. This is what is the generator for the Lie algebra, which you showed on your last part of the slide.
So for the general part, I just assume that we are forming the closed Lie algebra. I am not talking of anything about what can be the generator. That is for the whatever algebra you are considering. So generator will be depending on that. Here I am considering SU2 algebra. This is a very standard one. So I will be talking about that. So this is the standard SU2 generator. So for the general part, I have this first part where I have assumed general thing that is only I require the closed algebra. And that is sufficient condition to develop this driving protocol.
So there is no question in chat box or there is.
Okay, I have a couple of questions, Jayendra.
Yeah.
You know, this you mentioned about this laser irradiated graphene.
Mm-hmm.
They are able to generate a mass gap. Has it been done experimentally?
Yeah, people have done this.
That 2011 PRB paper is the experiment or after that?
That is a theory paper. Uh-huh. Before that 2009, there's Takashi Oka, there's a physical group B rapid communication probably. So they actually first time they talked about that.
Hmm.
And yeah, so people have done experimentally graphing the band, how to create. So that can be used as a switching. Okay, so whenever this, so that people have done that.
Maybe I'll write to you to get some more references about
it. Yeah, I also have to see that.
Yeah.
Probably, I can't remember whether in the paper which I mentioned, they have also discussed experiment. Maybe, probably they also mentioned
it. But I know one can dig it out. It's very nice. Mm-hmm. Now, this other thing is that through that, is it possible to, once you have next nearest neighbor coupling, to generate, you know, sort of a Kitaev type of model and, you know, this Ghose-Majumdar model, you know, because, you know, you need, for example, for Ghose-Majumdar model, you need next nearest neighbor coupling. Is it possible to tune such that the eigenstates will be?
Okay, so you're talking about the spin system.
Yeah, I mean,
next nearest neighbor coupling is possible to create. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. In principle, I don't see any problem of getting that kind of thing. I don't know what will be the exact driving protocol for that. But
you know, for your case, you have SU2, right?
Yeah.
So you cast this spin thing or even Ghose-Majumdar hopping turn. You just cast it in the form of, SU2 kind of thing, right? Nearest neighbor, next nearest neighbor.
Okay. Oh, you're talking about from my first.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so this my work is this, that if you are given Hamiltonian, I can't remember, long time back I did some work on this Majumdar group. Can't remember now exact the form. So if the given Hamiltonian is a linear combination of some closed algebra, then our formalism can be applied. So that is okay. So if you can give me a closed algebra in Hamiltonian, then you can apply my formalism. Okay. If it's not a closed algebra, because I doubt that, because the spin-spin interactions also involved there, that will probably break some kind of algebra, or maybe I don't know what, whether that's still in the algebra spin. Because this is SU2 algebra, but when you take the product of this spin operators, they may break that algebra.
Okay, got it. It may not be linear realgebra, then there will be problems. Yes.
So that's why this interacting problem is a bit tricky, unless if you do the min-pin kind of thing, like I just mentioned one, this superconductor, that the unconventional superconductor. There, if you on the min-pin level, if the Bogoliubov do all this kind of thing, you can convert everything into a two-band problem. So there also you can apply our formulas. If you want to get some particular kind of Hamiltonian.
Now, another thing, you have this Kapitza pendulum, where one high frequency fellow, once you integrate out, it effectively gives us a potential where the massive fellow gets trapped. Does this thing have analogy with, this present system? That is, of course, classical.
Yeah, Kapitza pendulum is a classic example of this Floquet, that in the book, that one of this review article, I just mentioned that they are starting with this Kapitza.
Twice.
Yeah, this book of, this is a big, very long review article, Advances in almost 100 pages. So at the very beginning, they have classified that this kind of system in the three different kind of system. One, Kapitza kind of, one is the king, our king Kray and something, and another one is this. There are three kind of system they are telling that. In Floquet domain, you can think of three kind of system. One is that Kapitza is definitely one class. So pendulum, which I have shown at the very beginning of the video, that is Kapitza kind of, that is called dynamical stabilization.
Okay.
Dynamical stabilization, because this in upside down, that one was not the stable point.
Correct.
But due to this periodic driving at the pivoting point, it has upside down, that one, that point is becoming a stable point. So that is the purely coming from the Kapitza.
Okay, are there any more questions? If not, let us thank Professor Bandyopadhyay for an extremely nice talk. A lot of things got clear.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Pani.